friends, in the today session we will discuss how to generate the hollow square or box or rectangular box using a function in C. Okay, so what I meant to say is that we will discuss how to generate a such kind of single line box. Then we will discuss how to generate a such a box within box. And finally, we will discuss how to generate such a multiple boxes. Okay, it means the basic idea is how to reuse. In the last session, we have covered or we have discussed about the function in depth. Okay, and in the today session, in continuing with that, first of all, we will try to use a GoToXY function, then try to understand the box coordinate in order to generate the box. Then we will see how this box can be generated using an ASCII value. And of course, in the practical session, we will cover all these three practicals. And the basic purpose of conducting this session is just to make you aware the importance of the function and how one can reuse the same code. Okay, that is the basic purpose of conducting the today's session. So let's start with the GoToXY function. The GoToXY function helps you to place the cursor at a desired location on the screen. Okay, and this is referred as your coordinate 1, 1, while this extreme right corner is referred by a coordinate like 24, 80. It means in all you have a 24 rows and 80 columns. And the syntax of the GoToXY is very simple. First of all, you need to specify what? A column followed by a row. So when someone is writing GoToXY 5, 10, it means what? The place the cursor on the screen at column 5 of row number 10. Okay. Now, in order to generate the box, what you need? First of all, you need to understand the box coordinate. So this is your R1C1 coordinate and this is what your R2C2 coordinate. It means you need a pair of coordinates. And in or once you know these two values, that is extreme left and extreme right corner, you can easily draw the values of these coordinates. Okay, so it means in order to generate the box, you need basically four parameters, that is R1C1 and R2C2. And finally, you can add an additional parameter called as BT, which is referred to box type. So it may be a single line box or it may be a double line box. Okay, and we are assuming the condition, the value of R1 should be always less than R2, while the value of C1 should be always less than C2. Now, how we can generate such kind of box? By means of what? The ASCII character. That is called as American Standard Code for Information Interchange. All the characters that we have on our keyboard have what? A certain ASCII values. So, some of them are referred as what? A non-printable character, while printable character, and these are what? Your extended ASCII character. So, using this extended ASCII characters, we are going to generate what? A box. Okay, so let us see. So, in order to generate the upper leftmost corner, you are going to use an ASCII value 218 if you want to draw a single line box. And if you want to draw a double line box, you are going to use what? 201. That is the ASCII values of printing this particular symbol. Okay. Similar to that, we have what? We need all these characters in order to generate the box for a single line box. And this character, ASCII character, for generating the double line box. It means in our coding, we are going to write something like this. Okay, the upper left corner 218, horizontal line 196, upper right 191, vertical 179, then lower left 192, then lower right 217. If the box type is 1, otherwise if the box type is 2, then we are going to assign these values, these ASCII values, to a corresponding variable. Okay, so I am simply copying this. Now it's time to do a practical session. So let us write an program. So first of all, we are going to include our two header files called as standard input output header file and console input output header file. Then entry point to executing language statement. So let's clear the screen first of all. Then specify the box coordinate. Suppose that you want to generate the box of this size. And your box type is of what? A double line box. Okay, so what you need to specify now? The prototype of the box function. So since we are going to pass a 5 integer values, so mention. And finally, write a box definition. So we are going to use the variable something like this. This is useful to specify the extreme left values. Then R2C2 for specifying the extreme right chord, and finally box type. Now define few variables, that is upper left, then upper right and horizontal line and vertical line and lower left and lower right. Okay, you may need the additional variable. Now, so what you need to do here, first of all, you need to assign the ASCII values to respective variables. Okay, so I have already copied those values, so I am going to simply use this coding. Copy and paste it. After that, we have done nothing. We already discussed about these ASCII values in our presentation. So what we have done, if the box type value is 1, then we are going to simply assign this ASCII value to the corresponding variables. Okay, that's all. So now it's time to draw a box. So for loop. So first of all, we will generate the horizontal line. So go to XY. Your column position is going to be changed, while the value of row 1 will be what? It will remain the fix. So printf percentage C, that is character, and you are going to generate what? The horizontal line. Now let's execute this part and see what is going to happen. Okay, so we have generated what? The horizontal line on the row 1. Now similarly, we need to generate what? The horizontal line on row 2 by changing the value of column and fixing the value of row 2. Printf percentage C, again what? The horizontal line. Let's execute it and observe what is happening. Okay, so I will give a better picture how it is happening by including here getch. The capability of what? Go to XY function. During each iteration, it is fixing the position of the cursor. Okay, so I hope that you understood how these horizontal lines are generating. So let me remove this part. Now again, what you need to do? Now you need to generate the vertical line. So simply copy this part. Now we need to fix what? We need to fix the column and we need to change the rows. So R1, it should be R2, R2, and fix the value of column fix, that is C1, and change the value of row. And we need to generate what? A vertical symbol. C2, and again here a vertical symbol. Let's check what is going to happen. So we have generated what? The horizontal line and vertical line, but our box is not proper. Observe the corners. Now we need to put the corners properly. It is not necessary that first of all you need to generate the horizontal line and then vertical line. You can also start first of all with what? Specifying the vertical line and then horizontal line. Now finally, go to XY. That is C1, R1, that is your extreme left corner, and specify the proper symbol over there, that is what your upper left. Then go to XY, by fixing the value of row 1, we are changing what? The coordinate, that is column position, and print the upper right corner. Then go to XY, C1, R2, that is the lower left, print the symbol, lower left, and finally go to XY, C2, R2, that is your lower right. So remember this, again remember the order is not important, in which order you are following. Over right. Okay, let's execute and observe. It looks perfect. once you have generated a box, now you can add or you can call the function more than once, no issues. It means in this case we are going to generate what? A box within box. You may call a single line box, no issue. Now remember that these ASCII values are very important. If you are assigned a certain other value, it may print what? Some other symbol. For example, instead of 205, if you have assigned a value say 65, what is going to happen? Let's see. For double line box. Absurd. Okay, so that's why it is important that you should assign a proper ASCII values to a respective variable in order to generate the proper box. So we have seen how to generate a box within box. So you may call a number of times, no issues. Now you may call additional boxes, no issues. For example, box 1, 8, then 11, 41, and box type is what? 1. Let's check. So there is no limit at how many boxes you can call one within another. Okay. Now, if you want to draw a multiple boxes, so instead of calling this method, what we can do is that you can use a for loop statement in order to generate that part. So let me put all these things within a comment. Declare few variables, that is row and column. So let's write a for loop for r equal to 1. R less than equal to 24 rows, R equal to R plus 4, and within that column C equal to 1, C less than equal to 80, and value of C is changing by say 5. Call the box function by passing the values r, comma, c, then r plus 3, and then the column c plus 4, box type is set 2. And let's execute the program. So it looks perfect. Now observe that we are calling this function more than hundreds of times. Now you can have what? Some little bigger box. It is up to you the what kind of size of box you would like to generate. So of course these boxes are very much useful while designing. Okay, so I hope that you understood how to generate this box. And now last important point, let me put it in a comment. Once again, what is going to happen? It is generating a single line box, that's fine. But what if by mistake I have written say something like this? Here the value of R1 is greater than what? R2. So let's see what is going to happen. Okay, so that's why it is necessary that you should check whether the coordinates are proper or not, so that you can write by coding. If the value of R1 is greater than R2, or the value of column 1 is greater than column 2, then printf wrong coordinates. And finally, return back to main program, or you can also quit. After what is going to happen? It is going to say what? Wrong coordinates. So you can put certain kind of conditions. Okay. So I hope that now you understood very well how to generate such kind of boxes. It's very easy, and observe that we are calling this function as many as time that you would like to call. Okay, so this is a reference book that you can follow. With that, thank you very much. Have a nice day.